Everybody, Matt Walsh, Mount Pleasant Country Club here with Mark Corky, Mall Access Physical Fitness here on Route 9 in Shrewsbury. What we're going to do today, during the doldrums of winter, we're going to show you two quick exercises before we get our off-season program going here in a couple weeks. To help you stay in shape, stay injury-free. You might be heading down to Florida, you might be there already. But these two exercises are really going to help benefit you in your game. It's going to give you some pelvic stabilization. It's going to get you more strength in your legs, quads, your hamstrings, and your glutes. So what I do is, if you have to take a lesson from me, you know I use the medicine ball a lot. I use it to show waist shift. I use it to show proper posture throughout the swing. What I do is say, all you need is a wall. Actually, don't even need a wall. I need a medicine ball. Which one do? In the golf posture, very important. If someone was to drop you something from 15 feet above, what you did, something heavy, what you would instinctively do is you would put your knees inside your feet, you put your elbows close to your side, and you would anticipate that weight. That's how you brace yourself for it. You wouldn't stand like this. You're going to get like this. And that's what you do in the golf swing. You step over the ball. So this exercise here, we got a medicine ball here. This exercise here, you want a nice wide base. You want to kick your left foot out a little bit. You want your elbows close to your side. You're going to hold the ball just like this. So this is actually proper posture for the golf swing. All I want you to do, real simple. Your hands on either side, you're going to load into your right leg with your chest, over your right quad, and you're going to release to the target. As you release to the target, you want to stay in your posture. You want to get your right shoulder over your left foot. So you're going to go just like this. Okay? If you feel your pelvis going like this as you're throwing it, you're weak in through your midsection. You need to work on your core, your glutes, stuff like that. Somebody like Mark Wood, he's an expert at that. He's going to show you another exercise to expound on what I just talked about.
So my name is Mark Wood, I'm one of the co-owners here at All Access Physical Therapy. I got my doctorate in physical therapy. I'm also a certified strength and conditioning specialist. This exercise is great for our golfers. We use it all the time. It's a great way to make sure our golfers, when they address the ball, are keeping their spine nice and straight, okay? So just for people, just with 2 feet, just to kind of teach yourself, to make sure, just what Matt said, that you're, when you address the ball, that you're keeping your knees, you know, your butt behind your knees, okay? What we do, to make sure, once we do it on two legs, we like to go to one leg. It ensures that we're not substituting from side to side. So essentially what we're doing, make sure we get our balance, keep our core engaged, our knees over our toes. We bend forward and then come up. Just like this, okay? This is a great way to work on your balance side to side. And you want to make sure your knees aren't caving in. So in the golf swing, if you get too much, you're going to start to shift side to side. You know, even that will tell you to fall out of your swing. To make this exercise a little harder, when you bend forward, you can add a little bit of rotation here, okay? So you can work on the full golf swing on one leg. If you work on both sides in about 3 sets of 10 for each, it's going to help you be more balanced. Also, make sure you're engaging your core. So hopefully it'll help you hit